Hello guys, let's look at scenarios in which in KCSE question 16 flowcharts are tested. Guys, if you compare those days and nowadays, those days flowcharts were either 8 marks, pseudocode 7 marks or vice versa. But nowadays the examiner is friendly, whereby we have general knowledge programming questions that add up to 6 marks. Or 5. So there is no way you will tell me that you can't score the first 5 marks. Like for example, in this paper 2015 KCSE question 16, we have list 4 web programming languages 2 marks. We have state 4 ways in which a programmer can make program code is set to 4. Then you can see we have 6 marks of general knowledge programming language. Then down there we have the first scenario. Of which we shall encounter it again, you'll realize that the examiner may give you a pseudocode, that is English-like statements. Then you are likely to come up with a flowchart. Definitely, when the examiner gives you a pseudocode, you expect him or her to tell you to draw the flowchart. And there is nothing easy on earth like drawing a flowchart given the pseudocode, so long as you know the symbols. So guys, here this is that is a pseudocode. You can see it is inclined or indented to make it easier for you. So we have 9 marks to do the flowchart. Then guys, we have the next question, the next scenario. You can see that the setting of nowadays is nice, whereby we have at least 6 general knowledge, that is general knowledge programming questions. Like now, state qualities of a good pseudocode. We have with an aid of flow chart diagrams, describe the following sequence. We have selection 3 marks. Then definitely now the examiner is giving you a story. Then you are supposed to come up with the flowchart from the story. That is the next scenario. Scenario number 1 was you are given a pseudocode, then you populate a flowchart. But in this scenario, you are given a story. Then from the story, you are supposed to come up with a flowchart and pseudocode. For example, draw a program flowchart that would accept 3 numbers and find their sum. If the sum is greater than 200, it adds that to the sum. Otherwise, subtract 20 from the sum. The program should display the result. So guys, here, you're just supposed to come up with a flowchart. Then we also have another scenario whereby you are given a pseudocode, an unabbed pseudocode. And also, once you see a pseudocode, guys, you definitely know that you're supposed to draw a flowchart. But before you go to that, look at question 16A. We have talked of 6 marks and below. That is the general knowledge programming questions, like with an aid of a flowchart, describe a loop control structure as used in programming. If you are keen enough, guys, you realize that the previous questions we have checked there, they are the same. So if you go through these 18-page flowcharts, these are KCSE flowcharts, not from any other press, you realize that once you go through this document, you'll be in a position to score 16 out of 16 in question 16, because it will definitely lead you to any question that NEC may test. Like for example, study the following pseudocode. You see here we have a pseudocode, and guys, I have advised you, once you see pseudocode, definitely the examiner will ask you for a flowchart. So this is also a KCSE question. So you can see if you proceed on with the other questions, this is 2018. You can just get the papers from my website. The URL is just down below this video. You realize that the next question is draw a flowchart. Then guys, we have another question. You can see what I am talking about. This time round, this has broken the record. It has asked for 8 marks. That is the general knowledge programming, that is the ideas or skills. Explain the term dry running as used in program development 2 marks. Then explain 3 properties of an algorithm. These are all in book 3. Guys, Remember, answer question 16 and any other three. Never answer questions, all of them, that is, and never skip question 16. You'll be penalized accordingly. You can also see a situation whereby NEC has repeated the same story. This paper was in 2019, the question above. You see now, you are given a story, then you are supposed to come up with a flowchart. So this is the trend, whereby either you are given a pseudocode or you are given a story, then from the story, you are supposed to come up with a flowchart. Like, for example, to qualify to get a driving license, an applicant must be 18 years and over. 10 candidates applied for the driving license test, draw a flowchart. You see, once you get a story, definitely you are being told to draw a flowchart. Then we have another situation, guys, whereby these guys or the examiner will draw for you a flowchart, then give you some input, then ask you for the output. Or rather, you are drawn a flowchart, then the examiner will ask you to interpret the flowchart. That is to explain step by step all the flow, what is happening on each stage. Like this one, guys, you are given a situation whereby if X is 5 and when X is 7, then what will be the output of the sum or probably any other thing that the examiner would wish to. And then, guys, once you are drawn a flowchart, definitely the examiner will ask you for the pseudocode. Just mark that. Once you see a drawn flowchart, definitely a pseudocode question must be there, carrying at least 5 marks. Then this person or the examiner here is asking us to modify the flowchart so that it can be used to get some of the integers. Once you understand the pseudocode, it will be definitely easier for you to do that. Then we have another question, guys, whereby you have been given a pseudocode. Definitely, just like I have said, once you get a pseudocode, definitely the examiner will ask you for a flowchart. So this is also another question whereby you have been given an algorithm or a pseudocode explaining what the value of P is, the value of Q, and then the input. Then if you use if function, the first part of if function is positive, that is yes. The second part, that is after else, is usually negative or no. So mark that. So when you are doing the flowchart, the first part of if function is yes, and the second part of if function is no. Once you know that, you definitely come up with a maximum 100% accurate flowchart. Then you can also see, look at this question, whereby I got question 16. I'm interested in question 16 of the 18 pages of flowchart interpretation. Guys, you see, write a pseudocode, 3 marks, draw a flowchart. You see, once you get a story, definitely the first question or the question that must be there, a question you must expect is right, that draw a flowchart. You can also get a story, then the examiner asks you for the pseudocode. And my advice is, once you are given a story, first of all, populate the pseudocode, then draw the flowchart. Once you draw the pseudocode, definitely you must score on the flowchart. You can see also this is another question whereby we have been drawn a flowchart, guys. This is KCSE 2016. And then this is the flowchart. Once you see a drawn flowchart, definitely there will be a question, write the pseudocode. Not draw a flowchart again unless you are being told to modify. So we have that question. This question probably was interpret the flowchart. Once you ask to interpret the flowchart, just explain in paragraphs what is happening. You can also opt to use the pseudocode, but use a paragraph because the next question after interpret the flowchart will be draw or write the pseudocode for the flowchart. So, you see. So, guys, we also have this question. Study the flowchart and use it to answer question that follow. You see, once you get such a flowchart, when you see an equation like S equals to 1, N equals to P, definitely the examiner will give you some inputs. Like now, here we have 48. Get the expected output of value Y if, of S if Y is 48, if Y is 800. So basically, once you go through these 18 questions or this 18-page document, you'll definitely open up and you'll be in a position to score everything. That is 16 out of 16 in question 16. So we have write the pseudocode that can be used to create a program by above flowchart, you see. So it is just like we have seen there. So here you see we have the flowchart, the pseudocode. So definitely the question will be draw the flowchart. Also, once you get such a thing here, you definitely expect that you will have a selection flowchart. Also, this one is the same. Here, once you see a schedule like this, score, grade, we have that is 80, less than 80 or equal to 80, 60 to 80, 40 to 60. Definitely, the examiner will ask you to draw the flowchart or write the pseudocode. Also, we have this one, or this is a marking scheme of the above questions. So you can see, if you are keen enough, you realize that the neck recycles the questions. The questions are like, if you go through 10 years from today backwards, you go through the flowcharts, you definitely score 16 out of 16, because the examiner here is testing a certain skill that is in the syllabus. He or she do not test any skill that is outside the syllabus. And that's why you realize that the questions are like a cycle. It's like just a conveyor belt. They are being repeated. It is either draw the pseudocode, interpret the flowchart, get the output, or being given a story, then modify the flowchart like that. Then we have, these are the marking schemes. Guys, from the URL given just down below this video, you can download these questions. These questions have been done with a purpose, whereby I have gone through at least 10 years from now backwards, trying to show you the flowcharts, the way flowcharts are examined, and the way the flowcharts are actually presented for questioning. So you realize that it is either you are given a drawn flowchart to interpret or to draw the pseudocode, or you are given a story to draw the pseudocode and draw the flowchart. Or rather, you are given a flowchart, then you are asked to modify or to identify errors from the flowchart. So guys, thank you very much for listening and watching to me. Remember to subscribe if you haven't done so. You can also ask queries from my WhatsApp. My number is just below the description. Thank you very much.